In today's video, we discuss health coaching and whether health coaches can carve out a professional niche that doesn't create undue risk of enforcement for unlicensed practice of medicine, psychology, or nutrition. I'm Michael H. Cohen, founding attorney of the Cohen Healthcare Law Group. Since 1999, our law firm has counseled hundreds of healthcare industry clients each year on healthcare and FDA legal issues. Health coaching is very, very popular. I've personally benefited from health coaches who've counseled me on nutrition and fitness. I've also had coaching on relationships, money, even my relationship to the stars. It's true. And I mean, those shiny beacons of light in the heavenly firmament, not celebrities residing in Hollywood. I like coaching, and I'm also the oldest of three brothers, and so while I don't consider myself a health coach and I don't charge for coaching, I'm always coaching. I'm giving advice. That's what older brothers do growing up. That's probably the reason I became a lawyer. I just enjoy giving advice. Anyway, we've counseled over dozens and dozens and dozens of health coaches, partly because that's the reason I first became interested in healthcare law, was my interest in energy healing. I found out that energy healers don't normally get licensed the way medical doctors and chiropractors do, so I came to study and see the way that medicine gets licensed as a potential stumbling block for practices like energy healing, hypnotherapy, and much more. Some of our most successful clients are health coaches, and the big issue you need to be aware about is the statutory prohibition against unlicensed practice of medicine. You see, the law defines the practice of medicine in a very broad way. It talks about diagnosis, treatment, prescription, and operation for any illness, disease, injury, and their host of other synonyms. It's very broad. Diagnosis and treatment are the principal words, and these are interpreted very broadly by the courts. I wrote a book some years ago and I looked at the way that these statutes evolved over time and basically how they came in with these really broad definitions and how courts understood treatment and diagnosis to mean just about anything involving human health and wellness. So while today we have a much bigger bandwidth for wellness as opposed to just medical practice, the practice of medicine statutes can still be an issue. We have a lot more on our blog, CohenHealthcareLaw.com, and you're welcome to look at our many resources. Thanks for watching this video. Please contact us. We look forward to speaking with you soon.